Hello. Now, welcome back to.
We've been expecting you.
I suspected it was you.
A pleasure as always, Yin. I keep doing that. You prefer Risha. It's good to see you're both in good health as well, Detective Bannings and Miss McDowell. And if it isn't Major Arendelle, I trust you've been keeping well since we last met.
I'm getting by. I've had my hands full since the last time we teamed up.
So good to see you remember. You were a valuable asset indeed. I wish I could be as satisfied with the sad state Crossbell is in. Thank goodness Master Shin returned to the Republic just before all of this began.
Indeed. It was quite the stroke of good fortune.
I'm thankful you contacted me, at least. Might I ask where Elia and Kia are?
You needn't worry. They're in the fortress behind us. After all, we wouldn't want them being hurt now, would we?
I wish I could say I didn't see this coming.
You made your position so obvious by not appearing during the chaos at the signing ceremony.
You're in Rufus's back pocket, aren't you?
Oh, how little trust you have in me. Or you perhaps trusted exactly what I do. The Supreme Leader made contact as we were considering our Crossbell branch's future under renewed independence. Once the elders gave their blessing, we decided to take him up on his generous offer.
You really are the worst.
Loyalty means nothing to them. They'll betray you in an instant if the price is right. What's more, given their formation and numbers, they knew exactly who among us would be coming.
Astute as ever, Yin. Yes, a kind-hearted informant told us exactly who we should expect, letting us be fully prepared.
An informant?
Don't tell me it was...
No. It couldn't have been Lecter. There would have been no reason to stop the EDF from arresting us if he was working with Rufus, too.
Oh, that's a fair point.
Are you sure you aren't just being too naive? But yeah, pretty sure you wanted him to suspect me, didn't you, White Orchid Dragon?
My apologies for the confusion. I simply thought it would be easier on you if you didn't know the truth.
And what exactly is that supposed to mean?
I'm starting to get it now. We haven't had contact with that many people since the ceremony. That basically narrows the informant down to someone in Armorica. Someone who knows us well enough to give him accurate information on what to expect.
Wait, who are you suggesting? Risha. No. Sansan?
What's she doing here? Wait, it couldn't be.
I told him everything he wanted to know. That you and two SSS members came to the village with the red-haired man who'd been to our restaurant.
What have you done to her? Is she under some kind of hypnosis?
Please. I may be capable, but you should know that such things fall outside my area of expertise. All I did was lend an ear to a kind-hearted young woman who wanted what was best for her friend.
Let's go home, Risha. The world will be a better place if we do what the Supreme Leader says. You won't have to do anything dangerous ever again.
Wait. It can't be. Sansan, you're doing this because you're worried about me?
Risha.
She's giving off the same aura the people at the signing ceremony were.
Must have gotten to her without her even realizing it. I guess it was dormant till something triggered it to make her loyal to the Supreme Leader. You've gotta be kidding. That's possible?
This power defies all logic.
Pardon the interruption, but But I do believe you'll have time for speculation as you're being escorted back to the city. Lao.
Certainly. I'm afraid we must take all of you into custody. Please try not to take it personally.
Stay on your toes. Each of them is skilled in Eastern martial arts.
Hold on. This wasn't what we agreed. You said you wouldn't hurt them.
Tan-san!
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Settle down. I merely rendered her unconscious for a short while. We'll send her back to the city with you. So don't worry.
Get ready. Sorry, Sal, but we'll be leaving here under our own power. Let's do this, Risha!
Of course! You won't have the time to regret what you've done! We'll back you up. For Kia and Ilya's sakes, too!
Forgive me, but we must.
I won't let you!
Don't give
Thanks.
In!
I won't let you!
I'm going. Now, let's settle this.
Right. Yeah.
Leave it to me. Stay strong, everyone.
Thanks
Thank you
much.
So
Why
much.
Not?
Behold my dance.
Okay.
Unbelievable.
It is.
Unbelievable.
Right cross.
Leave it to me. All for one.
And one.
Why not? Okay. Let's.
Death awaits you. All for one?
It's my turn. Keep strong. Let's go. Right. Back.
Rock cross.
Let's go.
You're a tough.
It's my turn. Stay strong, everyone.
Thanks
so much. I'm going. Moonlight butterfly.
I don't mind. It's down.
Attack. Death awaits you.
Keep strong.
Death awaits you. Now.
Mine. Right.
Go with my
Good to go.
I'm going.
Yeah. My turn. There!
All right.
Rock cross!
Right. Keep it up. Right. Right.
I
don't mind. This your card? Fine card
of course. Now, let's settle this in one fell swoop.
I got it. Good to go. It's down.
Attack.
Let's go. They're open.
I've got you. It's my turn.
Keep it up.
Leave it to me.
Now's
the time. There.
Of course. Now.
Fine. Good to go. It ends!
So this is the end.
Sorry, we got stuff to do.
Punk. Hey, look at that! Level 8, son.
Nice! I did it!
An impressive performance, Yin.
I hope you didn't think I'd be soft on you simply because we've been allies before. Hand over Kia, Ilya, and Sansan, or we'll leave you no other choice.
How are we supposed to stop her?
I suppose I should have known that even Lao wouldn't be able to defeat you now.
My apologies, Master Sao.
You're outnumbered, Sao. Give Kia back to us. You know this won't end well for you if you continue to resist.
I'll admit that you make a convincing argument. But unfortunately, a few observers have arrived to make sure I honor our agreement.
What?
Well, looks like you're in deep shit.
Oh, of course.
Is that
Garcia? What are you doing here?
He has Kia with him. Ilya's there too.
Risha.
Lloyd! Ellie! I messed up. Sorry that I got caught.
We found Kia as she was helping evacuate people in the city. But who was going to rescue her? That was when we thought to take her and the nearby Ilya under our wing.
What?
Hold on, Kia. We'll rescue you and escape here together. Don't worry.
You've been really brave. Just hold on a little longer.
Yeah?
Okay.
That's a jump.
You're not the same police brat from a few years ago, eh, Lloyd Bannings? For a split second, I thought that was Guy at the ceremony. Really come a long way.
Wish I could say the same about you. All I can feel is disappointment. I honestly believed you'd atone for your sins and turned over a new leaf.
Thought so too. Then I got offered as much turf as I wanted in this whole United Nation thing. Sounded like a nice way to get Ravach bet together. So I agreed to knock these guys into shape as commander.
Is that Ravach? Is that how you say it? I always thought it was Ravachi.
Who'd pick three huts and a cot over a one-way ticket to freedom? Gotta back the winning horse with its free mirror.
Did you say your goal is to get Ravach back together? That's why you're doing this? What?
Cut the crap! You honestly expect me to buy that, Garcia? You had your chance to escape when I was falsely imprisoned. You turned around and helped me. You told stories about my brother and gave me the perspective I needed. You picked me up when I was at my lowest. Now you want me to believe that you would side with a dictator just to take the easy way out? Like hell you would.
Lloyd, you're right. It makes no sense. Neither does Uncle Dieter's choice to side with him.
It's almost like there's some dark power
Maybe
controlling them.
You haven't come as long a way as I thought. Still sound wet behind the ears today. Either grow up. Or get your ass off the battlefield!
So you are going to offer your support. We do make for strange bedfellows, don't we?
I'm just tired of how long this is taking. Hoping it makes my skin crawl. But you best damn pull your weight, White Orchid Dragon.
I wouldn't want to disappoint you, old friend. You always did make my heart dance with excitement as an enemy. I hope you'll do the same as an ally.
Are they both Jaegers?
Great. A former regimental commander from Zephyr and a master martial artist.
Neither of them are to be taken lightly. Let's settle this, Tao.
Good luck, guys! You can do this!
We will. Just you watch.
We'll be there to save you before you know it.
That you believe. I
Let's
do not.
See if you're up for a real fight.
Shall we do battle? It begins.
Okay.
Yeah. It's my turn. Yeah.
I'm going. Prepare yourself.
Could be doing better. Okay.
Right.
Thanks much. Thank you.
Oh god. Oh god.
Better get ready.
Oh god. Oh god. Okay.
Let's see if you're up for a real fight. It begins.
Of course.
Mine. I don't mind. All right.
It's my turn.
Things up.
Zip it up.
All right.
Keep strong.
Okay.
Leave it to me. Here I go. Take this.
How did you miss?
Good to go.
How about a little fire?
Right.
It's my turn.
Zip it up. Keep strong.
I'm going. Come. Perfect.
Mine.
Leave it to me. Prepare yourself. It ends now.
I don't mind.
A little fudge town! On my mark!
Right.
Better get ready.
Perfect!
Right. Yeah, now!
I've got you!
Even I'm getting fired up.
I'm going!
I don't mind.
Behold my dance.
I don't mind.
Keep strong.
Why not? All for one.
And one for all.
Right. Ah, they're open.
I've got you.
Let us end.
Now.
Fine.
Leave it to me. Stay strong.
Thanks
Thank
much.
You so much.
Okay.
You're not here to play.
This one,
get it!
Behold my dance.
About time I...
I'm sorry.
No way down.
Okay.
Well, DAG ON FIRE! DAG ON FIRE! Alright.
Let's see if you're...
Yeah, I was doing good, too. OH, FRICK OFF!
Why not?
Keep strong.
I don't mind.
How about a little fire? Let's go!
You know what?
Let's go!
They're open!
I've got you! Leave it to me! Here I go! Take this! They're off guard!
There!
I'm going! Come! Perfect!
Fine!
Hey, yo! Board up!
Why not?
Now!
Thanks
Thank
much!
So
Good
much.
To go!
Rise.
Why not?
All right. Let's get some
right.
critical hits.
It's my turn.
Now. I've got you. Death awaits you. Come. Now.
Mine.
Jack.
Perfect.
Mine.
Sealed.
It's my turn.
Good to go. All for one.
Better get ready.
Death awaits you.
Rise.
I'm going.
Come on.
Hey, yo. It's my turn.
They're open.
I've got you.
Even.
I don't mind.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Thank you so much.
Leave it to me. Here I go. Take this. They're off guard.
There.
You're not.
It's my turn.
Yeah, what you gonna do now, son?
They're open. Everyone, move in.
I don't mind.
Behold my dance.
Good to go.
A little fun town.
Attack!
It ends.
Okay.
What you gonna do now, son?
Leave it to me.
Keep it up.
Yeah, let's go ahead and finish
this.
Ah, crud. Alright.
Take a deep breath.
Things up.
Come. Perfect.
All right.
Ah, crud.
Alright. What?
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Behold my dance.
And you're
dead. Let's go.
Oh, come on!
There!
Thanks much. Okay.
It's my turn.
Thanks. It ends.
Leave it to me. Here I go. Take this. Now's the time.
And
woo! I know I can always count on you.
I don't know if I did it.
Anything
nice, nice, nice. Yeah, dude.
Nice. I did it.
I've done it. I need to keep it.
Yes, sir.
I guess I didn't do it. Hey!
Damn kids.
Splendid.
Thank you,
Reg. Now's a chance. Risha, Ellie. What are you?
Just knock him out.
We did it.
Lloyd!
Kia, you're not hurt.
Aww.
Right? I guess I don't have anything to worry about if you have the energy to tackle me from behind like that.
Yep, I'm fine. Thanks for coming to save me. I never doubted for a second that we'd see each other again.
Neither did I.
Ilya, are you all right?
Risha, you came all the way here just for me?
Yep.
You look like you're totally exhausted. Take it easy. We'll get you somewhere where you can recover. Huh? They're all right!
Well, at least we finally managed to get things under control.
Risha, get away from her!
Oh, God!
What a shame. I nearly had you, Risha.
Oh, that's right. This is one of those, like, special cutscenes.
Those were terrific reflexes. You always do live up to my expectations.
Huh? Ilya?
Yeah!
It's good to see you two again.
He can talk?
I've come to resume my duties as your police dog.
What?
What?
Wolves?
That's
just
cool.
A bunch of mangy beasts. If only it were the beasts.
Hell are you guys doing here?
The Grouse Ritter.
Not bad. Wasn't expecting you to dodge that.
They're just as skilled as we heard.
All the more reason we couldn't have arrived at a better time. That Rufus fellow is proving to be even more dangerous than I thought.
What's the Grouse Ritter doing here?
No wonder the old gut was telling me things were gonna work out. Guess that makes me two for two today.
Take your fellow evildoers and be gone, fallen. Answer.
Ooh.
Your schemes have met their end.
So it seems. What a shame that we lost the element of surprise. How I hate letting Lloyd and Risha escape from my grasp, but oh well.
Is this some long con? Is this some long con?
Kidding me?
Guess the party's over.
And I was just starting to enjoy myself too.
Like, what is happening?
For letting you have, Kia. May we meet again soon, Yin and SSS.
You're part of Ouroboros, or? Oh, okay.
That outfit.
So it was you.
We'll cut things short for today. Enjoy your freedom while you can and have fun struggling against the inevitable. You're helpless to stop us now that you've lost your way.
What's that supposed to mean?
The curtain has risen on the show of a lifetime, and nothing can lower it now. So sit back and watch the fun unfold. The world will soon become one with Crossbell at its center, just as we've always wanted.
Ilya, wait! Wait! It's not true, right? Tell me you weren't the one who enslaved the people of Crossbell! Tell me you weren't the one who turned poor Sansan against us!
You'll have to prove yourself worthy if you want to play a part in this great performance. No performer gets to take the stage without an audition now, do they? I'm looking forward to playing judge.
Ilya!
Ouroboros really playing in the back seat in this game. They were so involved in the first at least Cold Steel 2, 3, and 4. Like... Okay. Nice. Good ending. I didn't actually expect it to be Ilya. That's a little bit of a surprise. I still can't get over the fact I called Rufus a C. Like, I made that as a joke. Well, not a joke. Like, I genuinely thought for a brief minute there that Rufus was going to be C. But then I saw Rufus and I was like, okay, so it can't be him. Okay, well, it is what it is.
Hmm.
You were quite punctual.
You bet.
I remember
so,
you.
And welcome aboard the Argo, the vessel of Nine Valley's new high-speed transport service.
Our pilot is a child.
We might have been better off on the ground.
I'll have you know that I'm a licensed pilot. And that's real rich coming from you guys. You look like a bunch of kids about to go on a picnic with their daddy to me.
Ooh, we got burned.
But boy, did I not see your daddy's ID coming. Who knew my mystery client would turn out to be our former Governor General, Rufus Albarea?
That is,
Oops. What? Do you prefer Supreme Leader now?
Like, what is happening?
Please. If I knew I'd be repeating myself so soon, I would have gathered my audience. That title is not mine.
But then...
I'm confused. Who's Rufus? That's this guy's real name. C was a nickname. So it's Rufus, huh? I think it's much cuter than C. I give it 85 points! Ooh, he kicked your butt, S.
Why would I care when I don't even get what criteria she's basing these on?
So are you famous then, Rufus? Everyone seems to know who you are. He's not just famous. He's super famous. He's the elder son of House Albarea, one of the four great houses of Erebonia, and he became Crossbell's first Governor General. Together with the Empire's Chancellor and Crown Prince, he led the country to all-out war, but then he got arrested after it ended. That's all the big common knowledge stuff, but trust me, I know all about the skeletons in his closet. Wow, you're so smart, Nadia.
Is knowing part of handling the unpleasant side of things?
Wow, you're so smart, Rufus.
Can she try not to stir up trouble with him?
I wonder what it's like to have a sibling. Do I have any out there? Cerberus is so cute! I hope I can pet him later on.
I'm afraid this side of the deck is occupied. You'll have to sleep elsewhere.
I wasn't planning to sleep out here.
Oh? Then what's brought you outside?
I wanted to go stargazing. What about you?
I wanted to take in the night air.
Since we're both here, there's something I'd like to ask.
What is it?
I know that you're a famous man, but are you a good man or a bad man?
Bad, though that would be putting it mildly.
So very bad?
Very, very bad. I have used anything and everything to advance my interests, be it titles, fame, or even those pure of heart. There is little point in feigning a moral compass when human lives hold no value to me. Or acting chivalrous, when all that does is hinder me.
Do you still feel that way?
I do. I'm using you, Swin and Nadia, to bring my designs to fruition, am I not? I'm also using those we met in the capital, like my brother.
None of that sounds like something someone good would do, yes. You really are a very bad man.
I'm glad we could come to an understanding. So, armed with that knowledge, what do you intend to do?
Am I supposed to do something?
I suppose a doll has no reason to care if a human is good or evil.
Being a doll has nothing to do with it. But were you hoping I would admonish you? Or perhaps comfort you?
Of course not.
Okay, then I still intend to do nothing. Whether I praise you for your deeds as a hero, or chastise you for your misdeeds as a villain, it won't change you at your core. You are who you are.
Just how does humanity look through your lens for you to think in such simple terms?
I don't know. I can't answer that when I'm still learning about what it means to be human. All I can say is, I don't see if you're good or bad, where you're from, or how you were raised. I don't see what you've done or haven't done, what you possess or what you lack, because none of those are what make you exist as a person. So it can't be that you suddenly don't exist just because someone decides to reject those parts of you.
That's quite a philosophical approach to the matter. Or perhaps that objective thinking is the most one of artificial intelligence can fathom.
I don't know. How could I know? Just to me, being is what makes a human a human.
Perhaps you're right.
And so, it's what makes you, you.
Perhaps you're right. I don't remember the exact moment I began to search for meaning in my life. My father elected to raise me as his own son, irrespective of the fact I was born because his wife laid with another man. He did so with the same ease he rejected his flesh and blood because he was born from a common woman. When I learned the truth, I finally understood that House Alberea wanted me not as a human being, but as a product of noble blood. It was so hard to bear that it made me sick. Was that all? Was that the only reason I existed? I refused to accept it. I couldn't take it. And as I turned my eyes from this terrible truth, a new, more terrible thought dawned upon me. If that was not the reason I existed, then what was? That was when I met him. It is said we seek that which we do not have. Through him, I sought the father I never had. I convinced myself that if I did as sons do and became more than he ever was, then I would understand the real reason for my existence. And there it was. At last, I had a goal, something to pursue. I stopped at nothing to make that goal a reality. There was no effort too ambitious, no principle too sacred to violate. But no matter what I did, it still wasn't enough. Everything I had done to secure my victory had led to a resounding, humiliating defeat. A defeat at the hands of my own brother, who, despite his unfortunate upbringing, had grown into someone strong and true. I envied him for that. But perhaps I should have known all along that a mere product could never hope to have a real, genuine purpose. The whole predicament would have been worth a laugh had it not been so deeply painful. Why am I here? What is my reason for being? Who am I?
You are who you are. I don't see what you've done or haven't done, what you possess or what you lack, because none of those are what make you exist as a person. Just to me, being is what makes a human a human.
Ha ha. Such nonsense. I thought you weren't planning to sleep out here. I'm unsure if dolls are capable of catching colds, but I believe you've taken in the stars enough for one night.